and welcome to Chalk Talk. I'm Melody Bonnet. The St. Tammany Parish school system employs some of the best teachers in the state. Thus, the competition is steep when selecting award-winning teachers. Three teachers have emerged as the best of the best within our parish. Let's visit the classrooms, talk to the students, and speak with these St. Tammany Parish Teachers of the Year who represent the best of what our school system has to offer. We'll first visit the Lee Road Junior High Kindergarten classroom of Debi. Schoen.
It dropped in the snow, and what happened?
They
couldn't find it. It's camouflaged, wasn't it? Let's think of some other things that are camouflaged.
Debi Schoen, an experienced teacher of 28 years, has spent 24 of those years as a kindergarten teacher at Lee Road Junior High School. She truly believes that teaching is her calling in life. She has touched the lives of thousands of young students who receive a wonderful nurturing and positive start from this energetic, creative, and hardworking teacher.
Miss Shane's a great teacher because she's nice.
Debi's kindergarten classroom is a bright, colorful, and child-centered environment that reflects her love for nature, literature, and learning. Debi always knew she was destined to teach. From the early age of 5 years old, she taught her collection of dolls. Her personal love of learning developed at this early age, and in spite of being a very shy and quiet child all through school, inspired her to become a teacher.
I love Shane because she lets us do fun things.
Debi's own personal teaching style is reflected in the learning centers throughout the room. She believes that kindergartners learn best through play and manipulation of concrete materials.
I like Miss Shane because she lets us paint.
Therefore, learning centers are a crucial part of her students' daily routine. According to Debi, learning centers enable students to make decisions, follow directions, and work independently. There are many rewards that come from teaching, but for Debi Schoen, the greatest satisfaction is in knowing that her greatest success stories are without a doubt her former students.
I love Miss Schoen because she's nice.
She strongly believes that the teaching profession is not about money and power, but the satisfaction of knowing that she has the only kind of power worth having, and that is the power to change and mold lives.
I love Miss Schoen because she's the best teacher in the world.
Congratulations to Debi Schoen, St. Tammany Parish Elementary Teacher of the Year, who provides her students with wonderful beginnings and shapes their young minds to accept a world of unlimited possibilities for a bright future.
I tell this to people every day. This would be a great honor in any parish in the state of Louisiana, but it's a particularly wonderful honor in St. Tammany Parish, where we have the number one school system in the state. I'm really lucky because I do what I love and I love what I do, and I get so much satisfaction from knowing the number of lives that I've touched through the years. We have so many great teachers in our parish, and it's truly an honor and a privilege to represent all elementary teachers in St. Tammany Parish.
We love you, Miss Schoen!
Let's now visit a classroom of gifted fourth graders at Lake Harbor Middle School in Mandeville. These lucky students are taught by Suzanne Buras, who not only was selected as the Parish and Regional Middle School Teacher of the Year, but also won the coveted title of Louisiana Middle School Teacher of the Year.
Logs. How many logs do you think? About 10 logs is probably good. Is that
normal? Suzanne Buras did not dream of being a teacher as a child. Her shyness growing up prohibited her from ever thinking that she could stand up in front of a classroom of children and teach. Yet, while working in remote parts of the world, doing Bible translation and literacy training, she discovered her gift of communication whenever she was placed in a teaching role. Suzanne believes that education should equip children to be thinkers and problem solvers. Part of her students' assignment on this particular day was to create their own fantasy kingdom after reading the Chronicles of Narnia out of everyday household items. Thus, turning trash into treasures is one way that Susan lets her students know that they are much like our early pioneers who learned to be among the most resourceful people in history in spite of their limited resources. Suzanne places a great deal of emphasis on collaborating with other students to accomplish assignments and projects. She is their facilitator, editor, encourager, and resource person. One of the resources that Suzanne makes sure her students use is technology, a tool that Suzanne says enhances and enriches the curriculum. Whether it's assisting her students attending a ThinkQuest workshop at the Instructional Technology Center or helping students use her classroom computers, Suzanne knows the value of integrating technology into the curriculum. She is the school's technology liaison, the webmaster, and trains others throughout the parish in the use of technology. Suzanne's activities and talents have allowed her to build many relationships in education, but the most important are with her students. The aha moments, the smiles of accomplishments from her students, and the wonderful sound of learning that permeates her classroom all make Suzanne grateful that she chose to teach. As Suzanne says, teaching is the joy of her life.
I feel so very honored to have been selected by the parish as well as by the state for the Teacher of the Year program. And it was quite a shock to me, actually, because I never thought of myself in those terms. I love teaching, I love the kids, I love all of the different things that are involved with it. And here at Lake Harbor Middle School, and I know at all of the other schools in the area, there's so many excellent teachers and just so many people who are deserving of this honor. I kind of feel like I'm sharing it with them. I know somebody had to be picked, one person had to be picked, but I'm kind of their representative.
I think Ms. Buras definitely deserves this award of Teacher of the Year because she has been the best teacher, even when like somebody doesn't understand, she will go back and explain it again and again until they get it right.
I like my teacher being the State Teacher of the Year because everybody's walking up saying, it's not fair, your teacher's the State Teacher of the Year. And I'm like, yeah, it's fun.
Congratulations, Suzanne Buras, Louisiana Middle School Teacher of the Year. Finally, let's visit the choral music classroom of Rick Watkins, Parish and Regional High School Teacher of the Year at Covington High School. He has passed on his expertise, enthusiasm, and passion for vocal music to a group of talented students who burst into song at a moment's notice.
All right, get in your positions.
Students of Rick Watkins are an energetic and talented group of students who, like their teacher, have a passion for music. They sing, dance, and perform a wide range of songs that reflect their ability and enormous talent as members of Covington High School's show choir. Choral music and theater offers an opportunity for all students to utilize their talents, and Rick has taught his students that it is the combined efforts of all of his students that allow them to achieve their goal of a successful production. Based on his own positive and uplifting high school experience, Rick has recreated a classroom environment much like he experienced, where the students feel safe and uninhibited to voice their talents. The students in Rick's classroom have a different attitude regarding not only the class, but the teacher as well.
He sets like standards up here so we can be up here, not just selling for whatever's not here, what everybody else is doing. So no matter what every other school is doing, no matter what the other students are doing, we have to do this up here.
Unlike other students in other classrooms, these students are in his class for 4 years, as well as participating in additional music classes and after-school rehearsals. Thus, a close relationship is forged between Rick Watkins and his students. He often tells his students that they are learning lessons in life, lessons not just about music, but all those intangible lessons that make his students better prepared to deal with life on life's terms.
It's like he goes beyond just music class. We have problems in math or history or any other subject, he makes sure that we do what we need to do and we get all the work done so that we can excel in all areas. And I know he probably wants us to all grow up and be Broadway movie stars, but it's not for everyone, so he makes sure we have like a well-rounded education.
Rick says he can't imagine his life without music. Rick believes that he is the luckiest person in the world because he gets to wake up each day and go to work to do something that he absolutely loves doing.
I enjoy teaching at Covington High School because I receive tremendous administrative support, and that allows me to go into my classroom and teach. And a lot of people I know can't say that. So I'm very fortunate because I get to go do something that I enjoy doing every day. I thoroughly enjoy working with the students. I particularly like high school students' energy. And once you channel that, it can be very rewarding. Getting it channeled can also be very challenging. But once you get it there, it's a great opportunity.
This passion, enthusiasm, and love for his work are what make Rick the award-winning teacher that he is.
He makes it interesting. He's why I want to come to school and sing.
Congratulations, Rick Watkins, St. Tammany Parish Teacher of the Year and Louisiana Regional High School Teacher of the Year. We usually associate flying kites with springtime, but for seniors at Northshore High School, this fall and winter has been the perfect time for designing and building their own kites. These kites will not necessarily fly, but they will help these students soar to new heights by meeting some short-term and long-term goals.
Teacher at Northshore High School. This project that you're about to see was done with my senior English 4 class. In the past, I have done leadership training for the National Association of Secondary Principals, and one of the goals of leadership is to teach kids how to set goals. I took the idea that I used in camp for setting goals and created a legitimate activity that could be done within the classroom with attaching a writing assignment to it. We started with was the concept of a kite.
Some goals, and you are going to design and develop a kite that will personally reflect who you are and what you would like to achieve.
And I taught them how to set 4 specific goals: a personal goal, a school goal for Northshore High School, an even more specific goal of a classroom goal for English 4, and a future goal, something that they wish to achieve on a long-term basis. They set a large goal. The large goal that a student would set would be to graduate from high school. They would then set 3 smaller concrete steps, such as passing English 4, attaining a 3.0 GPA, passing or raising their ACT scores. From the 3 smaller concrete steps, then for each one of the individual steps, such as to pass English 4, they had to come up with even 2 smaller steps. For example, I need to study weekly for vocabulary tests. They did this with a personal, a school, a classroom goal, as well as a future goal. The project here is 3-pronged. First part is to design a kite. The design of a kite has to incorporate their personality. They have to incorporate all 4 of their goals on the kite. They have to list the major goal, 3 concrete steps, and then on the tail of the kite is where they put the even smaller breakdown of the steps that they need to achieve their goal. The writing assignment was an essay in which they put together what their goals are, how they're going to attain them, and what they hope to achieve from this assignment. One of the best ways to help the students get an idea of what I expect is I keep a collection of past kites. They're given a kite and they are given 5 minutes to go through and evaluate the kite using the criteria I have given them that I will use to evaluate that their kite when they turn it in. At the conclusion of the project, the student brings in not only his kite, but he also brings in his 5-paragraph essay, and he presents the kite and the essay to the class. We're giving them tools to create a future that they want.
The state recently celebrated Educational Technology Week. According to State Superintendent of Education Cecil J. Picard, technology is a necessary tool for teaching and learning. It builds the fourth basic skill so needed in today's world, information literacy. The purpose of the week was to spotlight the important role of instructional technology in our schools and classrooms. Here in St. Tammany Parish, Channel 13 visited the computer lab at Bonne, Ecole Elementary School in Slidell, where Teacher of the Year April DiBenedetto and her students are making some big decisions regarding the environment. Principal Ginger Roper spoke with us about the state of technology in her school.
The goal of our technology plan is to improve student learning through the use of technology. And our technology plan addresses two areas. The first area is hardware, and this is our new computer lab. And we're also in the process this year of putting a new PC in every classroom through the use of fundraising monies, donations from individuals, parents, and businesses. And through the help of PTA, we have been able to put a new PC in all the grades this year, except for kindergarten. So there's not necessarily a direct correlation between the amount of money you spend on computers and increased student achievement. So professional development is the other area of our technology plan. By the end of this year, we will have 100% of our teachers trained in NTEC 1. We also have 22 teachers that will have NTEC 2 training this summer and some on a waiting list. So NTEC provides training for teachers, showing them how to support the required curriculum and standards through the use of technology, just to use technology as a tool to teach what is already required by the state and the parish. We have a PC lab, and we also have a Mac lab. And the teachers at this time have 1 to 3 computers in the classroom that they can use for AR testing or for students to work on individual projects. Parents who volunteer in the classroom to help students work on projects and on AR testing. I think leadership is a key ingredient to the successful integration of technology, and we're very fortunate in this parish to have visionary leaders at the central office level and the school board level who are committed to using technology to support the curriculum.
Before coming to the computer lab today, we have been working on decision environment, which involves the students making decisions on how the environment affects the community. Today, we're working on a final project where the students will write a letter to the community explaining their goals that they selected and why they selected. They're using Inspiration software to develop the map before they actually write their letter using Microsoft Word. On completion of the project, they will use Blackboard.com to submit the assignment in a digital Dropbox. Once they submit the assignment, they will go to discussion board. And the discussion board, they will discuss with one another about the assimilation, how they think the assimilation could have been different if they would have made different decisions, the outcome, because they were not elected as the mayor for their community because of some of the decisions they made.
I really like doing this lesson because we've got to do a lot. We had to make a whole bunch of big decisions. And it's been fun, even though as the mayor of Alpine, we didn't get reelected. We had a lot of fun doing it. Before I came here, I didn't know a bit about computers, and now I know about 3.5 floppies and CD-ROMs and like Blackboard, which is really, really fun, and a whole bunch of other stuff. Because before I came to Barnacle, I didn't know anything about computers or technology or anything, and it's helped me a lot, and I've been able to teach my parents and my sister about it.
A special farewell goes out to Simmie Fairley, administrative supervisor within our school system, on his recent retirement. As an educator who has dedicated 40 years of service to the school children of St. Tammany Parish, Mr. Fairley is a well-respected and much-loved role model who has indeed left his mark on the St. Tammany Parish school system.
Here's to the winners, lift up the glasses. Here's to the glory still to be.
Working with Simmie Fairley has been one of the greatest privileges of my professional career. He is a gifted educator and a wonderful person. He has served this school system as a teacher, an assistant principal, and a supervisor. And at every step along the way, he has been the consummate professional, earning the respect and affection of those around him.
To the heroes, those who move mountains, here's to the miracles they make us see. Here's to all brothers, here's to all people, here's to the winners all of us can be.
Oh, I know anyone that is such a listener and can listen to what people's problems are and can go through and follow through and help them.
Here's to the heroes, those who move mountains.
As someone who, who was fun to be around, someone who brought, along with the professional aspect of education and working with kids, the other side of being a friend to those of who had the opportunity to work with him.
Here's to the miracles they make us see.
I have always valued your opinion, and I've always felt that you were a person that I could come to for suggestions and opportunities that might be available to us.
He was a great influence on me. I guess I kind of represent a lot of students in this parish who could have this opportunity to say thank you to him. Unfortunately, they all can't, so I feel a big responsibility there in getting that message across that he influenced many, many, many students here in this parish.
He was one of those that you always had to give or use superlatives about. He was one of the smartest. He drove one of the fastest cars. He lived in one of the nicest homes. And he was one of the best teachers that I've ever seen.
Here's to all brothers. Here's to all people.
Quite a busy weekend for a special group of students who participated in the Louisiana Association of Student Councils 53rd Annual Conference. Using a lighthouse to represent the theme, Guiding, Lighting, and Leading, over 1,000 students met at Mandeville High School to take part in educational workshops, motivational speakers, entertainment, and student council activities. Hannah Rucker, assistant principal and chairperson of the event, shared with us what took place during this action-filled weekend.
LASC State Convention to order.
Yeah.
In any given school, student council is charged with governing the student population, planning social activities, being involved in providing a voice between the administration and the students, providing school service, and providing leadership training. In this particular organization, the Louisiana Association of Student Councils, it's a state organization that simply provides a foundation and a background for those organizations to come together under a single umbrella.
Mostly the purpose of the conference was to motivate the students and other student councils to teach them new leadership skills and to help them in their student councils so they could do a better job. Also to elect new officers for next year to better serve Louisiana.
The conference brings all the different school student councils together so we can share ideas and everyone can put in their good ideas and make their own student councils better.
LAC is absolutely incredible. You get so many new ideas from people that you're just meeting and people that you've met at conferences all throughout the years. Things take back to your school and ways to improve your student council.
I think the students played a really big part in what happened here. Of course, the advisors helped a lot getting most of the basic framework set up, like getting the motivational speakers in and getting all of the equipment in. But the students played a large role in getting individual decorations, and we played a large role in planning also.
We had planned two game shows, Family Feud and Name That Tune, to do that night.
Name a household item you could not live without. Okay, Armstrong Middle.
Icebox.
Icebox, like a refrigerator? Like a refrigerator, okay? He says refrigerator, okay?
Where are you from?
And the survey says...
We had basically all brainstormed at ideas, for ideas at meetings. And we all got suggestions from everyone in the student council, and we came up with the idea for these two game shows.
Okay. The theme of LASC this year is lighting, guiding, and leading, and that centers on the lighthouse. And it relates as in lighthouses provide a source of light and direction, much like a leader. They provide inspiration and have a vision of what they want to accomplish and then get others to help them work towards that goal.
We always have a charity, what we raise money for, who we raise money for, and this year was Angel's Place, and we raised about $30,000.
Miss Anita, this $30,000, $156.41 is for your dream, your Angel's Place.
Angel's Place is a local charity that was founded by Anita Guilford, that it's a place where kids with cancer can go for support and get to know other kids that have the same problem that they do.
Carry your candle, run to the darkness.
Come on, give a big hand, you guys. Thank you.
It is up to you to turn your challenges into opportunities, because life will always throw you an opportunity. But I want to tell you this, it's up to you and what you do with that opportunity that makes all the difference in the world.
And there's just so much energy here. You leave just full of life and leadership and new ideas, and you can't help taking a piece of this energy back with you.
Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed our show. Join us now for the sights and sounds of the St. Timothy Parish Schools.